Looking for a Canva tutorial to show you step by step how to create beautiful designs with ease? In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Canva for Work, Canva's paid service, which has neat extra features not available in the free version, so you can quickly and easily design your own social media images, presentations, flyers, invitations, and more. Stay tuned. Hi, I'm Sara Nguyen, your online marketing strategist, helping you build your business using social media with ease. If you're new to this channel, consider subscribing for all of the latest product reviews, social media marketing tips, and training. And at any time during this video, make sure you check out the description for links to all of the resources mentioned in this video. Canva is a remarkable design tool that allows you to create stunning designs with ease, even if you don't have any graphic design experience. I'm going to walk you through how to navigate Canva, the paid version, to start designing your own beautiful images. If you're looking for a training on how to use the free version of Canva only, I've created a video for that too. Check out the description for the link and to jump to the specific training sections. Let's go over to my computer now. To access Canva for Work, you'll need to log into your Canva account. Once you've logged into your Canva account, you can click on the little arrow of your name in the left-hand corner, and then you can click on Upgrade. Once you have done that, you can start your free trial, and here Canva will request that you put in your credit card details. If you don't want to continue your trial, you'll need to cancel it before your actual 30 days is up. Otherwise, Canva will charge you after this free period. So you can choose to use Canva for Work monthly or yearly after your 30 days free trial. So go ahead and enter in your credit card details here. So when you set up your brand kit, there are a couple of things that you can do. You can set your brand colors, so you can add a palette and select a couple of colors which are the brand colors that you will typically use. This is really handy for organizations who have very specific color schemes, and you can add the brand colors here so that when you use them, you don't have to search for the hex color. It's already set up in here, and you would do that by clicking on the plus button. You can put in the color code, or you can select the color from the color wheel. You just go along and keep adding the colors that you would use in your brand and have them all in one place in a central spot. You can add different palettes, which is quite handy too. So you could have different palettes for different documents that you use. And once again, it's about having this central point of reference to keep all of your designs consistent. You can add your logos in this section as well. So I'm going to go ahead and upload my logo here. And you can also upload your own font. So I'm going to click on Upload New Font. I'm going to upload this font into Canva. Canva will ask that you confirm that you have the rights to use this font. And this is a font that I have purchased, by the way. Once you've uploaded your font, you will see it in the uploaded font section here. And when you go back into Canva to create your designs, you'll be able to see your font in the drop-down section. So let's go back to all of our designs in Canva, and I'll show you a couple of other things that you can do in the paid version. With all of the designs that I've created, these all appear underneath the Create a Design section. And what I can do to make things a little bit more organized is click on the Add a New Folder thing here, and I'm going to call this YouTube Images. And now I can drag the designs that are relevant to this particular folder in here. So when I'm looking for my YouTube images, I don't have to scroll through all of the designs. I can click on the folder, and the specific images that I've filed are in here. And this just makes it a lot easier, particularly when you're working with lots of designs, to have everything categorized properly. Now I'm going to click on an existing design and open it up.
And this has been designed as a A4 page. What I can do with it now is if I click on the resize button, I can get Canva to resize this into the different social media images or different sizes here. And what Canva will do is that they will open up a canvas in these particular sizes and take this design and put it in there. You may still need to adjust the layout slightly, but it saves you a bunch of time as opposed to having to build it from scratch every single time. So I'm going to resize this into a YouTube thumbnail, a social media image, and a presentation. And then I'm going to click Abracadabra Resize, and Canva will open up a page or browser tab for every single design that I've chose to resize from. This is the presentation that it's resized as. I still need to move things around and probably increase the size of the fonts a little bit, but it's done a lot of the work for me. This is the social media image, and that looks pretty good. So that saved me quite a bit of time. And this is the YouTube thumbnail, so that will need a little bit of work. But they've done a lot of the steps for you, so you don't need to build it from scratch yourself. And this saves you so much time. This magical resize button, which I am personally in love with, is one of the best features of Canva. You can create a design once and then resize it really quickly. So if you have a blog post, you can create that image and then resize it for Facebook, resize it for Pinterest. As you know, Pinterest require a longer size in really quickly and really easily using this resize feature. Now, just to show you that font thing. So if I click on my text here and I go to the font drop down here, I can see the font that I uploaded in the uploaded font section. So I can choose that font as I would any other font that Canva allows me to. You will also see the brand fonts. So these are the fonts that I've chosen as my brand fonts, and I've set them in the actual brand kit. With Canva for Work, you have access to more Canva layouts than you would the free version alone. And this is pretty cool, particularly if you're using Canva a lot. You see the same layouts quite commonly. So if you have access to more templates, this gives you just a little bit more variety in your designs. The other thing that I love about Canva for Work is you get access to a lot more elements. So you have all of these additional categories which provide you with more stock images and more vectors and illustrations to use, once again giving you that variety in your actual designs. If you go to the Uploads tab, you'll see that you're able to add folders, and this will help you manage, once again, organizing your images into categories, making it just more organized and a lot easier to access quickly, particularly if you're working with lots of uploads and lots of designs. So you would click on Add a New Folder, you would name it, and then you would drag the relevant images into that folder. So then when you click on that folder, the images just specific to that category are there. When I go to download the actual design, clicking on download, there are a few more options here in the paid version. So when you click on the little drop down here, I can save it as an animated GIF or movie. And this is quite new, and I really do believe that this will develop and become extremely amazing. But Canva can create this as an animation, and it's extremely cool. So you can choose between these little styles that they have for you, and you can download it as a movie or you can download it as a GIF. So if I go ahead and click download as a movie, Canva will export this into a video format for me. If I click on download as a GIF, it will download this as a GIF format for me. Another thing that you can do using Canva for Work when you download your design is you can choose the PNG option, and then you can choose to set it as a transparent background. And this will save the file as a PNG file, and it will be transparent as opposed to having a white background. And then you can take this actual transparent image and you can use this and place it over colored images, whether it's in your PowerPoint presentation position, whether it's in another Canva design, but you've got the design here as a transparent design, as opposed to having it as a white background that it defaults to in the free version. The last thing I'm going to show you in this Canva for Work tutorial is this team section, and this is really cool. So with the team option, what you can do is you can add other people to this account. It does cost you additional for every team member that you add, but with these team members, you as the administrator can control their level of editing. So everyone can edit the designs, but you as the administrator, you can manage the brand kit, you can upload fonts, but other members at the member level can't edit the actual brand kit or the fonts. You can also have template designers, so people who will go in and create the brand kits, but they won't be able to manage the team. So the administrator has rights to manage the team, create designs and templates, and edit the brand kit. Template designers can't manage the team, but they can edit the templates and the brand kit, and members can just edit the designs. So once again, you're controlling access to the design components relevant to your needs. So this is another really handy feature of Canva for Work.
So there you have it, a step-by-step walkthrough of how to use Canva for Work so you can start creating your own beautiful designs with ease. If you found this video useful, make sure you give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And if you're looking for more ways to grow your business using social media, make sure you grab a copy of my social media checklist. It's a super simple guide to help you get up and running on the major social media networks so you can start leveraging the power of social to generate more leads and sales with ease. To get your hands on it, simply click on the link in the description below, and thanks for watching.